Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, this is the video from the chapter Image Segmentation. Segmentation actually divides the image components into several regions depending on to certain criteria. So in this regard, we actually started to learn how exactly the detection of isolated points can be done. Then the line detection, we have seen various age models, and further age detection that was very popular. We also demonstrated it using the MATLAB also. So in this particular segmentation, let us have a simple demonstration so that a fingerprint image we will like to take as a part of application. So for fingerprint detection, so we will like to get the fingerprint completely extracted as a part of segmentation, and whatever the topic regarding the watershed use also we have seen for the purpose of segmentation, we will like to also utilize it in the MATLAB environment so that you will be getting it more hands-on practice onto it. So let us see the details. So here we can start with our program. So I can take untitled script for programming here, and as usual I shall be marking the first line of the program to be the mention of purpose of having this particular program. So here I write, this is a program for simple image segmentation. So we begin with CLC, clear, close all, and now I can have the first model of the program. So for the purpose of segmentation, we should require the input image. So for that purpose, I mark here the first model, that is reading input image for segmentation. So now I can take F as input variable that will hold the input original image into the workspace environment, and initially I provide the use of imread to read the image inside the script, and I name it fingerprint.tif as the image. I expect this to be available inside the current directory, and with this I will like to give the name program, save unto this particular script. So program 7.m is the name given to this particular script, as well it can appear inside the current directory. And if you run this particular program, we expect small f as a variable to appear inside this workspace. These all other variables from the previous program we expect to get cleared from this clear syntax here. The command window is already with the clear screen, and unnecessary windows are also closed. So let us execute this particular program. Yes, we get small f as the input here. So it has been holded here with the dimensions 480 by 400 with the uint 8 type. So as it has only one band, we must say that it is a grayscale image. So let us visualize what particular input image we have provided for segmentation purpose. So as it has been holded by the variable small f, I give the input to the imshow command onto the command prompt with the variable name f here. So when I execute imshow here, the figure window has appeared to us. So this is the input image. From this input image, we will like to extract the complete fingerprint pattern extracted. The rest of the noise into the background, we don't want. So for that purpose, we continue this particular programming. And initially, we will like to have the variable with the name count. We specify initial value to be equal to 0 here. Now capital T we are supposed to use as a threshold here. In this particular chapter, the image segmentation after age detection, we have seen the very popular and the potential, that is thresholding here, then the region related segmentation methods we have seen, the use of watersheds also we have seen. So here capital T will be acting as a threshold here, and we calculate the capital T as the mean 2 of f here, the mean value we can obtain here, and here we can set a threshold that separates the image into the two regions. So the mean two dot, the mean two syntax we have utilized here, and another variable we also require that I name done here, and we write here initially with the value false here. Now we shall be using the while loop here. So we take the help here, so that is not equal to done. If it is, we shall carry this particular while loop. So it is count is equal to, that is count plus one, the increment we can make. Then we can have a threshold here for the new value. The image we can write small g as a variable computed. If f is greater than capital T, the threshold value, then we have the computation of t next as the variable name with the computation of 0.5, having a multiplication by the asterisk with the bracket here. The bracket holds the mean value of f of g. F inside g we provide here, and we add it here, the mean of f in the bracket minus g here. So this we terminate with the semicolon. Then done is equal to the absolute we require here. So abs is the syntax. Here we have the difference, that is capital T minus T next, which is less than 0.5 here, and capital T we can assign by the simple calculation of T next here. So here we can end up this particular looping, and G we can assign the computation by the syntax here, im to bw, provided the inputs are, one input is f, and here we have t divided by 255. Now the program script we are finished with. Now the portion is of display. So display we are making here. So very first of all, I am show small f, that is the input we have provided. We don't want to get it suppressed, hence no mention of semicolon at the end. Then with the separate windows, so using the figure as the keyword, we show the histogram as well. So I use the MATLAB syntax im hist here, and that is applicable of course to first of all the input image. Then again we require a separate window with the figure. Then we can show the result of this segmentation using the thresholding that has been folded into the G here. And lastly, here we have the figure to separate out the display of histogram of the new image. So I am hist for the operand G here we have specified. So we have saved this particular script, and now we shall try to run this particular program and expect it error free. So here we have this particular script for simple image segmentation purpose, and with this application of the while loop here, we expect the display here. So we hit the run here. So we obtain in total 4 windows. So the first window showing us the input image, we have not mentioned the title, we will definitely give it to. The second window is showing us the histogram of the input image, so it has this particular nature onto this particular graphical view. Now the output that we have obtained after thresholding, that has been displayed here. So this is the output of segmentation, segmented image we must say, and after segmentation the corresponding histogram has been shown here. So let us first of all name these particular figures so that there will not be any kind of confusion in mind. So here we provide the title as image before segmentation. Similarly, this is the title, as this is the histogram, we write here histogram of the original image. Then for the third line, we provide the title. So the variable g holds the segmented image, hence we simply write image after segmentation. And at the last line, we specify histogram of thresholded image or segmented image. So we have actually made the image a binary one exactly. So this is the script here. We run this particular program. Yes, here we have the titles, image before segmentation. Then we have the corresponding histogram, image after segmentation. So here you can compare image before segmentation and after segmentation. So see, this noise that was in the surroundings of this fingerprint that has successfully been removed up to some extent, and the fingerprint pattern that has been successfully captured to some level here. Still some salt and pepper noise is present, but initially also the original image has the white spots here. So for this purpose, whatever the region filling we have learned in one of the earlier lectures, that particular process we can have applied onto this segmented image, and we can improve our results here. And if you compare the histograms here, this is the histogram before segmentation and histogram after segmentation. So putting a threshold here and shifting all the components to nearby zero, and in this case to the nearby 255. So here we have only two logic levels, either complete black showing here and complete white showing here. So complete black has been shown by zero, complete white has been shown by one onto this particular histogram. Whereas for this, we have this particular strip where we have a gradual transition from complete black to having various gray shades denoted up to the complete white at 255. So this was a simple script here that we tested onto the fingerprint image. If you want to get this checked onto another image, let us say the input we provide here by imread, and we provide here tomato2.jpg. And also we require to get it into the grayscale as well, hence RGB2 gray I must mention for the input F here. So with the changes saved here, I will like to run this particular program. So you can see the grayscale input image before segmentation. So you can see a tomato onto the light background here. So we want to extract this particular one. So let us first of all have the output here. So output of segmentation is like this. So if you compare the two, this is the figure before segmentation, figure after segmentation. Whatever the reflection you find at this particular spot onto the object, that has been a complete white here. So it is the case of thresholding simply. So the complete background has been a complete white here. So this is simple segmentation comparison of image before segmentation and after segmentation we have. Along with, we have the two histograms. So we can see here the histogram of the input image is quite bimodal here. So putting a threshold somewhere here, but we have calculated with respect to some formulation and obtained the corresponding histogram with the two logic levels only. So now, to understand the segmentation better way, we have gone through the sequence right from the detection of isolated points, then the line detection, edge models, edge detection. We have gone through the understanding of thresholding. Then we have the segmentation based on to the region based methods. Then we have the segmentation by using morphological watersheds. So how exactly the watershed is there that we are supposed to carry with taking a new script here. So let us mention a new script here, and we begin here with first line here. So I mention simply watersheds for original, and the case we will be taking noisy image also. So we begin with CLC, clear, close all. Then the first module we shall be taking, the not reading, we shall be generating an input here. So in this case we specify capital A, the variable that will hold a checkerboard pattern with the input value 32. So we write here checkerboard with the input value 32. So if you save this, let us name this program8.m will be the file extension, and if you run this particular program, so you get everything cleared here, and the input variable we have generated, that is capital A. So 256 by 256 dimensions of double type we have obtained here, and we will like to have visualization of this A here. So I make uint 8 type, not exactly necessary. Let us visualize. I am show A. So here we have the checkerboard pattern with the value 32 generated here. Now for this image we will like to have the noise added, as well as to show the watersheds of the original and the noisy image. So I mention the module here, that is addition of noise to image. So now capital B as a variable I will like to take here, that will be holding the noise affected image. So to apply the noise to the image here, we have the syntax here, I am noise, and here we provide the input A. The type of the noise we can specify here, that is salt and paper type of noise with the value 0.1 here. Now we can have the corresponding watersheds of this particular images. So let us have the comment watersheds for images. So very first of all, I take capital A1 as a variable, and let us have the application of watershed syntax. The input shall be capital A with the 4 as another value. Then we have computation of B1. So for B1 again we use the watershed, and here we provide capital B comma 4 as the input to it. Now we shall be having a display. So display of images is the line here. Now we write here I am show, and very first of all we provide capital A as the input, and now the title we provide here, that is original image. Next to that we separate out the window with the keyword figure, then use I am show, and the input is A1. The input shall be first of all capital B, and the title we shall specify, that is noisy image. We again use the keyword figure, then I am show. So this time capital A1 is the variable we shall be using, and we can specify the title here, that is watershed of original image. We again have the keyword figure for the last line. Use the I am show again with capital B1 as the variable, mentioning the title. So title should be within single quotes, and here we specify watershed of noisy image. So this completes our simple script to show you how exactly the watersheds are. So we have saved this with the name program 8.m, and if you run this particular program, we expect it error free. So we have the total four figures. So this is the figure 1. I maximize here. This is the original image. Figure 2, I maximize. That is noisy image. So here you can compare. If I get back to the original image, you can see there is no noise inside the original image. But after application of salt and pepper type of noise, you can find a noisy image here. Now we have figure 3. So this is the watershed for the original image that is completely noise free. And now here we obtain the final result, that is a watershed of noisy image. So because of noise, so this particular pattern that used to be very, very precise here, that has got changed because of the availability and presence of the noise here. So I suppose this particular simple script has definitely helped you to enhance your knowledge regarding the image segmentation. So simply we have tried to have few selected images to be segmented using the thresholding, and the use of watershed also we have described. By the next lecture, we shall be addressing some more points regarding image segmentation, and I suppose that if you want some more information, you will definitely subscribe to our eKIDA channel for more details. Thank you.